JaVale McGee and Shaquille O'Neal, two NBA big men of different generations, different body shapes, and different skill levels who did not particularly care for one another. Shaquille O'Neal has been an analyst for most of JaVale's career, but Shaq and JaVale do not have your average analyst-player relationship. They have a sort of big brother-little brother relationship. Not in the sense that Shaq looked out for JaVale or anything like that. No, certainly not. More in the sense of Shaq teased JaVale until it became a real fight so vicious mom had to step in. Seriously, their moms got involved. Though this beef took place after Shaq retired, the centers did know each other as players a bit. In their first on-court meeting, McGee was a rookie, Shaq was in his 17th year, and Shaq was unstoppable. He played so well, he bucked the notion he was getting too old for back-to-back games. He totally destroyed JaVale, which lines up. Shaq was a 14-time All-Star with 4 rings. McGee was a rookie, still learning to manage his giant body. There were no hard fouls, no words exchanged, no on-court beef at all. But Shaq wasn't going to be on-court for much longer. In 2011, Shaq retired and joined Inside the NBA. And just from the way he was introduced, it's clear he wasn't going to be your typical analyst. Please note the t-shirt design in which Shaq is not just a Greek god, but the other hosts are feeding him grapes. He soon debuted a completely new segment, Shaqtin A Fool, a blooper reel in which he and the other hosts make fun of players for doing make-funnable stuff. It could be seen as mean-spirited, and I'm sure players don't love to be featured, but it's packaged as nothing more than playful teasing. And like, come on, bloopers are funny. Laughing at others makes me feel better about myself. And I'm not the only one, because Shaqtin A Fool is super popular and has grown to include several 30-minute segments throughout the years. Shaq went after everyone, from end of the benchers to the best of them. Nobody was safe. And the guy who was especially not safe? JaVale McGee. From this authoritative goaltend, to this ill-advised no-look pass, to this bobbled alley-oop, McGee was on Shaqtin a lot. In fact, JaVale McGee has been on the most Shaqtin A Fool episodes out of anyone. Other guys have been on the show repeatedly, but Shaq called JaVale his favorite, and even had a signature cadence when announcing his clips.
Number 3, JaVale McGee!
JaVale would often appear more than once in an episode. Sometimes instead of showing 5 different players, Shaq would just show 5 different JaVale mistakes. McGee's the only player to win Shaqtin A Fool MVP more than once. He was featured so much, the other hosts started defending JaVale, pointing out when Shaq's clips were kind of a stretch, like this questionable goaltend.
Actually, that was a pretty good block.
I don't think that was goaltend.
I think that was Shaq. Shaq, I don't know.
But their protests weren't heeded, most likely because Shaq was scream laughing too hard to hear anything. How'd JaVale feel about all this? Well, in 2013, he did an interview on Inside the NBA, and it seemed like everything was cool. Shaq was nice.
All the type of stuff that you used to do, I used to do back in the day. So we just want to say continuous success, and we love you, brother.
JaVale was funny.
No press is bad press, that's all I gotta say.
JaVale did throw in some charged language.
What is it that you like about Shaqtin A Fool?
I don't watch Shaqtin A Fool.
But that didn't do anything to slow Shaq down. Even JaVale getting injured didn't slow Shaq down. In the 2013-14 season, JaVale fractured his tibia and only played 5 games. Yet, he showed up on Shaqtin 4 times and received 2 midseason awards, Worst Moment and the Lifetime Achievement Award. The award special was in March. JaVale hadn't played since November. Did JaVale really deserve all this ridicule? He was making all these flubs, but as a player, he wasn't that bad. With the Wizards, he gradually improved until he was a starter. He was in the dunk contest in 2011, and I gotta say, he did not look like the embodiment of clumsiness when he dunked 3 balls at once. In 2012, he was traded to Denver, where he played fewer minutes but had some big games. Most notably, a playoff game where he grabbed 14 rebounds and scored 21 points with showmanship. He bounced around the league and struggled with injuries for a bit, but in 2016, he joined the Warriors and played the best basketball of his burgeoning career. And despite the fact that JaVale showed up on Shaqtin A Fool more than most players, he didn't turn the ball over that much more than other players. His turnover percentage during his Shaqtin years was in the 12 to 17% range, even dropping below 10% when he joined the Warriors. In contrast, Kendrick Perkins, another frequent Shaqtin star, had a turnover percentage in the high 20s, even getting up to 32% toward the end of his career. But what the stat sheet doesn't reveal is just how spectacular it was when JaVale turned the ball over or otherwise messed up. He wasn't a terrible player, but my God. The fall is one thing, but why throw the ball as hard as you can while falling? What instinct is that? Plus, it's not like JaVale had a perfect reputation before Shaq went after him. In college, he once kicked the ball into the stands because he was upset at a foul call. But hey, I'm sure we all have stuff we regret from college. In the pros, when McGee got his first triple-double, it took a long time to get that 10th point, even though the Wizards were running plays for him. When he finally got it, he celebrated by hanging on the rim and getting a tech, all while the Wizards were down by 20. He did block 12 shots, but that wasn't the story coming out of the game. The story was JaVale McGee is obnoxious. Whether he deserved it or not, McGee eventually revealed he actually wasn't cool with being made fun of on national TV night after night. But Shaq didn't care and kept putting JaVale on the show, sometimes for pretty minor infractions. When Kenny tried to defend this clip of JaVale getting a steal but missing a layup, Shaq just shouted his lack of journalistic integrity over him.
It wasn't a bad.
Yeah, I know. It don't matter.
You know what? I have
don't
a feeling.
It wasn't bad.
No, it's personal, Kenny.
Then Shaq noticed McGee's new haircut. In response, JaVale accused Shaq of acting like a minstrel, comparing his chicken outfit to that worn by Burt Williams. Burt Williams was the first black comedian on Broadway, but he also had to wear blackface and play demeaning roles for all white audiences. Shaq responded in what I'm assuming was an attempt to lighten the mood without losing the upper hand. Then Shaq fired back a little harder. He aired a new segment just for JaVale McGee. It was a loose parody of the Doctor Strange movie trailer that strung together over a minute of JaVale McGee lowlights, many we had seen previously on Shaqtin A Fool, including this fallen toss move from his Denver days. The segment was too much for JaVale, who headed back to Twitter with an expressive message for the veteran big man. He also implied Shaq was weird for thinking about him first thing in the morning, but he was tweeting all this at 4 a.m. Shaq responded, and while it's never a good idea to put threats of violence in writing, you gotta remember, Shaq threatened to smack people all the time, especially Charles Barkley. JaVale replied with the charged language we've seen from him before. Shaq accused JaVale of only having confidence because he's on the Warriors. JaVale said Shaq makes fun of him whether he's on a good team or not, in his own words, of course. Also, JaVale called himself a grown man in the same sentence he talked about nuts in mouth via emoji. Just something I found interesting. Shaq implied some violence again, as he's wont to do, and added some hashtags calling McGee a few different kinds of asses. 5 minutes later, he hit JaVale with a nickname and a Photoshop job that's rude but impressive for just 5 minutes. He had to source the photos and everything. Later that day, during business hours, the Warriors reached out to Turner Sports to talk about Shaq picking on JaVale. And Turner was like, yeah, we know. After the Warriors practiced that same day, Steve Kerr defended his center and went on to say Shaqtin A Fool was actually doing damage to JaVale's reputation, using himself as an example. Kevin Durant also fielded JaVale questions, sticking up for his teammate and adding that Shaq had some unfortunate moments of his own. Shaq definitely did not want this beef to spill over to KD, but he had no intention of laying off JaVale. While Kerr and Durant couldn't get through to Shaq, there was one person who could. His mom. Lucille O'Neal told Shaq to leave JaVale alone. She was defensive of her son's show, but felt the Twitter feud crossed the line. Since moms were allowed in on the beef, JaVale's mom spoke up too. Pam McGee is a former WNBA player and a college star who won back-to-back NCAA championships. Her reputation had shielded her son from criticism in the past. And she did not exactly agree with Lucille O'Neal's characterization of Shaqtin A Fool. Shaq said he'd listen to his mom, though it should be noted he also never admitted he did anything wrong. A few months later, JaVale did more than simply not mess up. He won a championship. He was a contributor off the bench throughout the playoffs, including scoring 16 points in Game 3 of the Western Conference Finals. And perhaps best of all, Shaq was true to his word and left JaVale alone. Though you might think spraying champagne directly at a camera at close range would be too much for Shaq to ignore. The next year, JaVale and the Warriors won it all again, but he still hadn't escaped the damage Shaqtin had done to his rep. His championship status was often an afterthought to his time as the unwilling star of Shaqtin. He joined the Lakers in 2019, and his younger teammates look up to him, but also say things like, he's actually a student of the game. He actually knows basketball. These should be inappropriate things to say about a center with two rings. Despite the lingering effects, it seems the beef has run its course. Shaq has gone so far as to say he has no beef and things never got out of hand with JaVale, despite written evidence to the contrary. And to this day, Shaq hasn't featured JaVale on Shaqtin A Fool again. He even complimented a JaVale highlight in 2018.
This is a great play right here. JaVale McGee, he's back! JaVale McGee is back!
This playful-turned-nasty beef has been put in a Tupperware container and shoved to the back of the fridge. Sure, there'll always be a faint smell on JaVale due to Shaqtin, but the beef won't ever be fresh again. Thanks for watching, everybody. Don't forget to click subscribe, and while I have you, may I suggest this Shaq-Dwight Howard beef? Or perhaps you'd enjoy this episode of Weird Rules, where Shaq smashed real good.